To know that I went through challenges in my life, and I went through issues that probably other people might have thought that would hinder them from becoming anything. You can overcome so many obstacles, and I felt like I had the voice, so I needed to say it.
Missy also went public about the domestic abuse she watched her mother endure all those years ago. She became a spokesperson for Break the Cycle, a nonprofit organization dedicated to helping battered women.
When Missy went open about the abuse, I was like, this is our secret. You don't tell the world what happened. And it was like, Mom, we have to. We have to let people know that we made it. She says, that's how you deal with it, Mom. You get it out in the open. I have to get these scars off of me. You need to get these scars off of you.
Having those conversations was very therapeutic. It was a major release. I can breathe now, and I feel good about it.
Coming up, a crushing loss changes Missy's life forever.
I just felt like if I ever, you know, would have to talk about her in this way, she would be here to hear it.
When Behind the Music continues. After two huge albums, Missy Elliott was on fire. A prolific writer, producer, and solo artist whose distinctive style had changed the face of hip-hop.
She's a bitch.
But she was just getting started.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Moulin Rouge.
In 2001, Missy produced a star-studded remake of Lady Marmalade for the movie Moulin Rouge, featuring Pink, Lil' Kim, Maya, and Christina Aguilera.
Working on Lady Marmalade was so hot. To be able to produce four major artists, I was on a high.
Mr. Moon, yeah.
I thought it was really fun. A chance to work with Missy. I was just like, how can I not do this?
They looked at it like, well, she got a track record. We've heard the work that she's done before. We trust her with this whole thing. And we did it. And it was amazing. Amazing.
Thanks to flawless execution and a saucy music video, Lady Marmalade was a tremendous hit, earning Missy her first Grammy.
I call my mother, she's crying. I'm like, oh God. So I'm happy.
Missy was about to score another Grammy, her first as a solo artist with her third album, Missy So Addictive. With club anthems like Get Your Freak On and One Minute Man, the album's raunchy sexual edge was a first for Missy, though not the first time she had defied expectations.
Listen to me now, I'm lasting 20 rounds, and if you want me, then come and get me now.
She felt like she wanted to display the sexier side, the more sexually liberated, edgy, push the envelope side.
Tonight I'ma give it to you, owe it to you, I want you to come prepared.
The song is a very sexy record. It's a side that people don't get to see from Missy.
Pick me up, show me what you got, cause I don't know, no one.
I think that message was for all women to say it doesn't always have to be about, like, love and romance. Sometimes it's about show up, do the right thing, and get the hell out of here. And that was just a really powerful moment.
Missy's fans responded as the album went platinum and became her highest selling to date. But Missy's happiness was short-lived. On August 25th, 2001, word spread that her close friend and collaborator, Aaliyah, was involved in a horrible plane crash.
We were in Jamaica and somebody came over and you know, broke the news to us. For the first couple of hours, we spent the time just trying to verify whether or not it was true.
I know that people make up terrible rumors. So I'm thinking it's just one of those rumors. I tried to call her phone. I'm gonna keep calling until I hear her voice. And when I didn't hear her voice, I realized that it's real.
Singer and actress Aaliyah was killed last night in the Bahamas. Their small Cessna crashed just after takeoff.
Missy was devastated. It was literally, you know, losing a family member for her.
I would never think that I would have to be here. I'm sorry. I just never thought I would ever have to be here. I just felt like if I ever, you know, would have to talk about her in this way, she would be here to hear it. And just to sit here and to know that she not here. I'm sorry.
Coming up, Missy's terrifying brush with her own mortality.
The doctors literally told her at that point that she was in danger of stroking out.
My nervous system shut down. Like, that's scary.
When Behind the Music continues. In 2002, after one of the most emotionally intensive years of her life, Missy Elliott went back to work, penning an R&B ballad called Can You Hear Me? An homage to her fallen friend, Aaliyah.
Aaliyah, can you hear me? I hope that you're proud of me. Me and Tim, we've been doing our thing. But it's never been the same since you had to go. Ain't never met a friend more incredible.
Missy included the track on her album, which she aptly titled Under Construction.
Life is short. Your friends, family, when they gone, that's it. You don't get them back. So I said, let me make a transition and fix things about me. That's what made me think I'm a work in progress. I'm under construction.
Is it worth it? Let me work it. I put my thing down, flip it and reverse it.
While grief inspired the album's title, the tracks were pure Missy.
If you got a big, let me search it.
She delivered another groundbreaking video for the hit single Work It, reinforcing her bold and imaginative reputation.
I wait for Missy videos. They're like Michael Jackson videos.
Like a Halle Berry poster.
You always know that there's going to be something that we had never seen, something innovative that was going to make you want to watch it again and again.
After selling over 2 million records, Under Construction became Missy's highest selling album to date. Up by This Is Not a Test and 2005's The Cookbook, Missy was hotter than ever. Living under the spotlight, Missy had also noticeably slimmed down. And for a woman who rewrote the book on body image, her sleek new look was met with mixed reviews.
A lot of her fans saw her weight loss as her selling out because she always advocated for loving yourself for who you were and not changing who you were for anyone else.
But Missy wasn't selling out at all. Privately, she had been dealing with a life-threatening problem.
The doctors literally told her at that point that she was in danger of stroking out, that she was at stroke level with the, you know, how high her blood pressure was.
This is a doctor telling me for my health, if you want to stay around for a long time, then you need to drop pounds. And I realized how serious it was, so I went on a serious diet.
Resolved to make a change, Missy hit the gym 4 times a day and shed over 60 pounds.
I lost weight, you know, not because I felt like this is the model look, or this is what an artist is supposed to look like. You know, I was comfortable with my size. It's just when your health come into play, that's a whole nother story.
In the spring of 2005, her health took another scary turn.
She had been feeling tired and her weight would go up and down drastically.
I was eating, but I was just losing weight. I had been feeling sick. And you know, the mood swings is up and down.
It was really, really rough for her because she didn't know what was wrong. That was all kind of a very scary time for her.
Over the next 2 years, Missy's health steadily deteriorated. And her constant fatigue and fluctuating weight soon gave way to bouts of depression. Then in the fall of 2008, her physical decline reached its breaking point.
One day I was riding in the car and I realized that my foot couldn't hold a breakdown and my leg started shaking real bad.
Her hands was just trembling.
Then I started having dizzy spells, bad dizzy spells. And I realized I had a knot in my throat and it was huge. I knew something was wrong. I was very scared.
Coming up, Missy faces her toughest battle yet.
The doctor said, you have to take a radioactive pill. I'm like, what is this disease? What do I have?
When Behind the Music continues. Watch extended interview clips and more from this episode at behindthemusic.bh1.com. In 2008, Missy Elliott was diagnosed with Graves' disease, a hyperthyroid condition that compromised her nervous system and threatened her livelihood.
The doctor said, you have to take a radioactive pill. I'm like, what is this disease? What do I have? Like, that's scary.
Missy immediately started radiation treatment and chose to keep her condition private, quietly coping, away from the spotlight.
My nervous system shut down. You know, your skin is dry, your hair fall out. You wake up, your eyes feel like they got rocks in them.
She started having one of the more classic symptoms, which is your eyes bulge a little bit so that her eyeballs, you know, didn't sit in the socket.
I don't think anybody would know what that feel like. You looking at yourself and now my eyes has changed the structure. You know, that's a lot to deal with.
Like so many times in her life, Missy met this challenge head on. And under a doctor's care, her health has greatly improved. Battle tested, Missy remains resolute, refusing to let anything stand in her way.
I still deal with it now, but it's controllable. You have to stay positive and you have to keep positive people around you, just keeping you upbeat. But, you know, I'm good now.
It's sort of like there's another hurdle that she's come across, and it's just like she's the bionic woman. She just keeps going.
Today, Missy is as busy as ever.
What's cracking?
She's putting the finishing touches on her own new album and working with her own stable of artists, including her latest, Shireya.
Gotta keep going. I just want to see what happens after that. Let me just see freestyle, something in the second verse. Here we go.
I want people to see me as not just the artist, but see me as a writer and a producer. I've been doing this for a long time.
No, so look, you gotta make sure that you know, you keep your energy up the whole time. It's not about just being able to dance. All of this stuff is a package. It's not just a pretty face, because I hate when it's just a pretty face. It's gotta be something else. Now you push play and let me show you how it's
done. Oh, all right then.
A true pioneer, her influence has spread far and wide, fearlessly clearing a new path for both men and women who want to challenge the conventions of the music industry, not just on the mic, but behind it too.
Missy has paved the way for us women being confident, knowing that dreams really do come true. You know, you can really believe it is possible, no matter what you've experienced, you know, that may have been hard, you can make it through.
She came into the music business to do what you're supposed to do, which is change the face.
Enough of that, back to the beat.
I feel like I was a part of a music change and opened a door for people to be creative and have fun in your videos. I pray to be amongst the legends when I'm done, but I ain't done yet.
I'm really, really hot.
No, I ain't done yet.